Oh. keep him on campus next week.
Thank you.
Let's go, New Waterbury! Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. Oh, boy. Well, it was 2 minutes left, huh? MVP.
Oh, French trains have started moving again. Full service should be restored by Tuesday. And Parisians were overjoyed to have their metro back, at least some of the lines. An end to 22 days of walking and massive traffic jams. It's truly great, he says. After 3 weeks, we were fed up. Railway workers, known as les cheminots, were the first to go out and the first to go back. Their leaders claimed a big victory. In the end, the government will not change their pension plans. They can still retire at the age of 50. The strike cost the French economy billions, the kind of money the government was desperately trying to save. Paul Workman, CBC News, Paris.
Haitians will choose a new president tomorrow. As Keith Vogue reports, in a country where politics has traditionally been shaped by violence and corruption, the huge effort to make this vote as fair and as free as possible.
The intimidating presence of an international military force throughout the country has curtailed the violence that once characterized Haiti. With soldiers around, neighborhoods are safer, and that's prompted a cautious optimism. Club Med, for instance, has decided to reopen its resort here. It was closed for the past 8 years as the country went through political turmoil, military coup d'etats, and a shocking reign of terror.
What is safe? Because the country is becoming better. I mean, there is no big deal with the security for now.
There is less violence generally and less political violence in particular, but there's still some. This house behind me and the people who live in it were recently targets of political violence.
Whoa.
The house belongs to Gérald Elysée, the government's appointed delegate in the town of Gonaïves. It was stoned, ransacked, and set fire to in the middle of a night last month. It's politics, she says. She's not sure who did it. Perhaps someone who wants her job. RCMP officers are still training the new Haitian National Police Force. Everything is rushed. Marc Raphael, in the green shirt, was recently made a police inspector. In the RCMP, that would normally take between 15 and 20 years experience. He was promoted after just 6 months.
We're not scared, but we have to be prepared in case of anything. But basically, we are ready for it.
And they had better be. The UN forces are scheduled to pull out in February. Then Haiti will be left to itself. Keith Vogue, CBC News, Gonaïves, Haiti.
And that's the news for now. For CBC News, I'm Paul Hunter. Now, back to hockey night in Canada.
Back live in Los Angeles, Toronto 3, LA 1 at the end of a period of play. As you know, Doug Gilmore factored in with an injury late in the first period. Before we get to that, we want to show you the other night Doug's helmet lying on the ice in San Jose led to a turnover that cost the Sharks a goal. So Gilmore used his head that night and again tonight. A little misfortune here as the shot from the point catches Doug going in behind the goal on the temple. The right temple, as you see, he's received stitches and we sent Scoop Don Cherry. I can't believe this. You, in the middle of a professional hockey league game, walk in the room to ask how he is?
Dougie Gilmore's all right. Good Kingston boy. Roll back there and not miss a shift, I guarantee it.
So he's A-OK. Don went in there just for the helmet. Doug Gilmore and the Leafs against Los Angeles, Series 2 next on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
This holiday season, give him the Gillette Sensor XL. With protective microfins, the best you can give, the best a man can get.
I feel ecstatically happy about being part of such a magnificent life.
The final seasons of a life filled with wonder, Monday on Land and Sea.
Sir, they're in the shapes of little portals. And when you walk, they bark.
Shopping for the holidays?
We have 2 gigabytes, 16 megs of RAM.
We have a suggestion to help you through it.
It's a virtual reality map. Look out, we're being invaded by spacemen.
Come to Wendy's for a Monterey Ranch chicken sandwich. It's a seasoned whole breast filet, processed Monterey Jack, and a dollop of creamy ranch dressing blended with bacon.
That way everyone gets something they love for the holidays.
Come to Wendy's for a Monterey Ranch chicken sandwich today.
Maritime Radiator is ready to handle your emergency. They've been in business for over 26 years and are experts when it comes to radiators, heaters, and gas tanks. Maritime has one of the largest inventories of radiators in Atlantic Canada. Now you can purchase a new gas tank for great savings over most dealer prices. And remember to have your car's cooling system professionally checked for safe driving. Maritime Radiator, 2642 Roby Street, next to Midas Muffler. Maritime Radiator.
CBC News gives you the complete picture. Weeknights at 6, Nova Scotia News comes first on First Edition. With reporters throughout Nova Scotia, First Edition is about you, your stories, your province, and your place in this fast-changing world. Then at 11, watch the Maritimes Tonight. Check up on your neighboring provinces and catch the latest news from your own backyard. Watch First Edition at 6 and the Maritimes Tonight at 11 on CBC for the complete picture.
Pick up holder and your arms. There is nothing else like this in the industry.
Customers have told us they want touch zones to feel friendly. The fabrics ought to be the best, ought to be the feeling of quality. I really believe that this Taurus is setting a whole new pace for the Ford Motor.
Redesigned, re-engineered, reinvented the 1996 Ford Taurus.
This portion of Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Ford of Canada, makers of the ultimate in luxury, the 1996 Mercury Sable.
Well, as Don Cherry told you moments ago, Doug Gilmore wouldn't miss a shift, and he'll be out to start the second period. The Leafs with a 3-1 lead, all three goals on the power play. Gartner, Momesso, and DiPietro. Lacroix, that late goal for Los Angeles. Let's see if that can give the Kings a big spark in the second period. 3-1 Leafs were underway. Lacroix, Gretzky, and Granato are out, and Boucher flipping it in. They've added an assist to Boucher on that goal by Los Angeles. Lacroix from Gretzky and Boucher. Gilmore at center. Can't catch up with the pass, and Cowie finds Gretzky. Ahead it goes to Granato. Tony Granato puts a shot. Goes after the rebound in the corner. Lacroix behind the net. He's bumped by Gilmore. Lacroix goes down. Puck cleared on the right side, but kept in by Granato. Gretzky behind the net. Takes the look. Banked it off the side of the net. Now Granato after it. And a penalty coming up against the Leafs. Here's Cowie fanning on the shot. And Gilmore touching it. And we've got a penalty coming up against Toronto. And in the first intermission, we asked Pat Burns about the impact of that late Kings goal.
Well, it's an important goal for them. It gives them a little bit. We had them where we wanted them in the corner, and we didn't follow the game plan on that play. We lost the puck in the neutral zone, and they attacked 3-on-2 with Gretzky on the ice. You're going to score. The Kings can score goals. There's no doubt about that. We had them where we wanted. We let them back in. Now we have to get them out again.
Lacroix had that goal, and now the Kings are going to have a chance to cut into the Leafs lead a little more with Doug Gilmore in the penalty box.
Flashing penalty to Gilmore. Before the first minute of the second period is completed, Larry Robinson, the 18th coach in the history of the LA Kings, only three have lasted three seasons or more. Bob Berry, Bob Fulford, and Tom Webster. I got a feeling this guy's going to be fine.
Kings 0-3 with the man advantage. Curry down low to Kristic. Burrows out in front. Yatchmanev behind the net as Kristic tries to set it up. It's the door in the path. Shot doesn't get through. Puck cleared around the board, since Sidor is able to keep it in. Randy Wood hounding him. Back to Kristic. Gary Curry at the right point. There's the shot right on. Potvin steers it into the corner. Wood goes after it. Sidor pinching in. Yushkevich tried it free. Got it to Andrzejczyk, and he'll loft it off the clock. And they'll whistle play down with 46 seconds gone in the Gilmore Minor.
If there's one thing Andrzejczyk can do better than anybody else in the league, is that little flip shot. This time he got way too much height on it, and it bounced off the clock. and he's upset because it's going to cost him about 160 feet. But he can really do this, and he can do it under pressure, and he can do it in a hurry. And the problem is, if you miss doing that, it rolls right to the guy in front of you. So we've seen Anderchuk do that in front of the net and put it up into the roof. He can do it all over the ice. Got to look like you with the sandwich. This time the Leafs get it all the way down the ice. Pressure penalty killers on. Matt Sundin and Benoit Hogue. Here's Granato. He's hauled down at center ice. Play continues. Lacroix, Gretzky also up front. Lacroix couldn't knock it down. And Ellis takes his time and sends it 200 feet. He's about shot the Leafs, 15-12. And here comes Gretzky. Over the line, the back pass to Granato. Granato trying to thread it in front, hit Ellis, who hit it with a high stick, and as Sundin touches it, plays whistle down.
Well, this is not only a small crowd, but rather unenthusiastic by L.A. standards. Here's Pat Burns. He's given you two different looks this past week. And clean shaven, a nice new sport coat. Glasses, a sporty tie.
You'd think with the winds, if he was superstitious, he'd stay with the same look.